Hi, hello, good morning. Welcome to today's session. In the previous session, we were discussing about the features of federalism. So, relating to the topic, we were discussing the first, second, and third features of federalism. So, with recalling the first three features of federalism, let us go for discussing the other remaining features of federalism. So, first feature is there will be two or more than two different levels or tiers of government in federalism. And second one is each level or each tier will be having its own jurisdictions. And jurisdictions are mainly relating to administration, legislation and taxation. Third one we discussed and we came to know that the jurisdictions adopted followed by different levels are mainly specified in constitution, and these jurisdictions are mainly specified, mentioned in constitution, and moreover they are guaranteed, assured and protected by constitution, and there is no chance for any level of government to violate the means, principles, ideals mentioned in our constitution. So let us go for discussing the fourth feature of federalism. So it makes clear explanation that unilaterally means without approaching any in the sense the highest authority or the highest administering body to the nation, it is always central government. And here unilaterally means only central government, only union government is not having any such provision or power relating to make an amendment, to make a changes to the fundamental provisions of constitution. There, if it requires, it need to approach, it need to take the consideration of both the level of government. That is, the amendment of constitution changes, if it requires to make any existing law or existing policy or existing such matters. So it need to collect assent, consent of all the regional government and central governments together. So that is the fourth feature of federalism. So unilaterally there is no provision for any level of the government to make changes to the fundamental provision of constitution, and for that it requires consent or opinion of both the levels of government. Then next feature is the judicial system or courts, the third organ of the government established. It acts as interpret. It acts as the protector, it acts as an umpire, in solving the possible disputes which may arise in between different levels of government, different organs of the government, different people, and even relating to different matters. So whenever such kind of disputes arise in matter relating to exercise the respective powers of central government and state governments, then courts or judicial system, it acts as an umpire or the person one who protects from injustice. So fourth and fifth is unilaterally only central government is not having power or only state government is not having power to make an amendment, to make changes to the existing fundamental provisions of constitution. If it requires so, then it need to consent the both the levels of government. Then courts or judicial system acts as the person in solving the disputes between the central government and state government in exercising their respective powers. Let us end today's session and let us begin discussing the other remaining features of federalism in tomorrow's session. So take care of yourself, stay at home, stay safe. Thank you one and all.